And we're back.
We're back. Happy Halloween weekend.
Halloween. Bachman and Bachman here.
I'm Randy.
I'm Tal. And we have some new viewers this week, I understand.
Yes, we've got new viewers.
And so if you haven't watched one of these before, it's sort of what normally happens when we sit around with guitars. We lapse into half-remembered songs we haven't really ever bothered to learn properly. And we just started televising this when the lockdown started. So
this is about our
30th.
No.
Yeah.
Our 30th show?
Yeah.
Wow. 30,
big 30.
And see, we'd be rich if we were getting paid.
I know. Well, on that note.
Even a buck a show.
On that note, if you push, what is it, like on YouTube?
Yes.
Push like and then subscribe. That will help us get to the point where maybe we could get money from YouTube for doing these. And it will just help cover our expenses and stuff.
Sporting a new guitar. Not, this is our nylon string show. This is a Godin. Phenomenal guitar. Nylon string. And we had one for Tal, but something went wrong with it. So Tal's using our spare guitar in case the string broke. We'd have to grab that. So Tal's playing that. He's got one just like this, but something's wrong with one string. We can't play it. But we'll be back playing it.
And you should talk about the company.
Well, this is Godin Guitars, a Canadian guy. Fantastic Canadian guitar maker. This is an absolutely drop-dead beautiful guitar. Very well made. I tried one in a couple. There's a great store in Victoria called Guitars R Us. No, Guitars Plus.
Guitars Plus, yeah.
Guitars Plus. The guy's name is Kurt. Great guy. Went in and tried all the Godin guitars, and the necks were too thick for me. When you're a rock and roll guitar player, you kind of like a certain neck, like a Gibson or a Fender guitar. The other Godins are for classical music, where you have to sit like this and you play bar chords. I don't play bar chords. I use my thumb. So this is a special Godin guitar. It's called a slim neck, so I can play with my thumb. Great, and great sound. And like I said, we got another one. We'll be playing both of them next time.
So we're going to see how these songs sound on nylon string guitar, so let's get to it. You got your first one.
I've seen this guy many times. I've known him for about 50 years. Last time I saw him was at Royal Albert Hall in London. I knew every song. I sang every song. I don't even know if this is the right tempo. Okay, let's go. Just yesterday morning, let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plan they made put an end to you. Walked out this morning, and I wrote down this song. Just can't remember who to send it to. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought I'd see you again. Won't you look on down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. Gotta help me make it through another day. My body's aching and the time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. And oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Yes, I always thought I'd see you again. So. Walking my mind to an easy time, back into the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines and pieces on the ground. And oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Yes, I always thought that I'd see you again. And oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought I'd see you again. Thank you, James Taylor.
I saw him play once, and
laid back, right?
Yeah, he's super laid back.
Mr. Super Laid Back is really cool.
I never really got into James Taylor, but I was really impressed by this one show because every single vocal note was like it was auto-tuned, but it wasn't auto-tuned.
No, he's got a really smooth voice. He plays a very nice guitar as well.
Pretty difficult to do that.
Okay, what's the story?
Okay,
on this?
Well, I thought.
Okay,
you got to give it to one of Canada's greatest songwriters, Mr. Paul Anka.
Here's the story.
The last year I was invited to Canada's Walk of Fame, where they put your footprints in the sidewalk, and I'm there, and you know other people are in there, Sarah McLachlan and Bryan Adams and stuff. They were inducting Jim Pattison, who's one of Canada's richest guys. He's about 90. You got to give this guy credit. He goes into work every single day. But every day,
yells at people, fires people.
Well, for 50 years, he's been every Saturday, he takes his wife out for a dinner date, and every Sunday, has lunch, a dinner with his family. And then he works like a dog the rest of the week. And so Paul Anka came and did this song, which is basically My Way. And he sang it his way. He's singing about Jim Pattison, and they're inducting him into the Canada's Walk of Fame. And halfway through the song, out comes Warren Buffett. One of America's richest guy. And they were up there singing, these two guys, Jim Pattison and Warren Buffett and Paul Anka. It was really a very cool moment. So congratulations to those guys. And they're both the same guys. They're family men, and they're great businessmen. And this is how Paul Anka got the song, which you heard in France.
Okay, here's the quick story.
You take
so
over.
Paul Anka goes on vacation in France. This is in the late 60s. He hears a song called Comme d'habitude, I guess you pronounce it, or something. And it's a fairly pedestrian French pop song. And the lyrics in this French version of the song, which would turn into My Way, are really quite
depressing.
Deflating and depressing. And it's about a man and a woman trapped in this completely loveless, hollow relationship, and they're both pretending. And so the whole song, all the lyrics, are a laundry list of all of these things that happen every single day that are so boring. And the tagline that he keeps saying is this, comme d'habitude, is as usual.
Oh.
Right? So it's like, we got up and we stared at each other and we didn't speak as usual.
Boring
as usual.
And
then you went to work and you know, I went to work and we didn't talk to each other as usual. And then we came when we ate dinner, we didn't really have anything to talk about as usual. And it just goes on and on. So it's really, I mean, not an inspiring song at all.
But the melody.
But Paul Anka hears it and he thinks, well, there's something to this, and it was a minor hit in France. And so apparently, this is, I mean, if the internet can be believed, what happened is he gets the idea to do an English version, not a translation, but he's going to write completely different lyrics for English, for an English version, and he's going to try to write it for Frank Sinatra in particular. Who's asked him for a song, and Frank's busted Paul a few times. Why didn't you ever write me a song? You wrote this guy's song, that guy's song. What about me?
Tom Jones.
What am I, chopped liver? So anyway, and so Paul has the thing. And so he goes to the French songwriters and the publishers and he says, I want to do an English version of this song. This song's already had its run in France. It's done what it can do in France. I want to make a whole new thing out of it. And apparently he gets the publishing rights to his English version, which he's going to help create, plus a cut of the song, because now he's writing
lyrics.
New lyrics, for $1.
Oh.
Right? Because the pitch is, if you say no to this, you'll never make another cent on this song.
Right.
No one's ever going to hear it outside of France, but I think I can make it big. So he gets, I think, all told, like 60%+. We'd have to ask Paul. 60%+ of the whole pie of royalties from his English version. He writes the English words, pitches it to Frank. Frank does it. It becomes Frank's signature song. Elvis does it.
Anthem.
And so
we're going to
do a quick all versions. So we're going to do a quick little French version. We're going to do a little bit of the English version, and then we're going to do the Gypsy King Spanish version, and we'll see how it goes.
All right.
Je me lève et je te bouscule. Tu ne te réveilles pas comme d'habitude. Sur toi, je remonte les draps. J'ai peur que tu aies froid comme d'habitude. Ma main caresse tes cheveux presque malgré moi comme d'habitude. Mets-toi, tu m'étonnes les dos comme d'habitude. And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friends, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway, but more, much more than this, I did it my way.
To the Gypsy King service.
Yo sé que yo vendrá, no vendrá, por eso ya tanto la olvido. Deja nuevo amor, tanto,
oh man,
como el mío. Deja a la vida.
This, I screwed it up.
De tristeza, deja la vida a mi manera. Yo quiero ser nada más. Requeriré y recordar un nuevo amor, o mejor, quisiera olvidar, tanto la dejó. Quisiera vivir, hay nada más. Up the lyrics on that one.
Well, when you went into full rhythm, I couldn't hear my guitar at all. Can anyone out there hear my guitar? Okay. Thank you. Can't you?
What?
What's that?
I don't know.
Getting a secret message.
Secret message. Okay, question quick. George Bolton says, I was wondering if Tal was named for Tal Farlow, the guitarist.
Of course.
Okay. Ron Singer says, do you and Fred think you'll do a follow-up album to Bachman Turner, especially if Fred moves here?
Well, Fred's got to move here first. He's stuck in Winnipeg now shoveling snow already. Fred doesn't want to move here, so... I would never say never, because I said never before, and we got together and did an album, but this COVID is changing a lot of things, so it's changing Fred, it's changing me, it's changing where we live. There might not be any gigs anymore. Nobody buys albums.
The world
albums.
Could explode tomorrow at this rate. That would be good.
We're on the verge of the American election, which is in about 5 days.
Well, we don't want to get into that on this, but okay. Susan Gilmore says, did either of you ever cross paths with Stevie Ray Vaughan? We love his music, love the blues, love your train wrecks, hi to Coco. To Stevie Ray Vaughan.
I never crossed paths with him, but I was inducted into the National Musicians Hall of Fame, as was Double Trouble. So I was there getting inducted. So was Peter Frampton and Duane Eddy, and so was Stevie Ray Vaughan, but he was obviously passed away. But Double Trouble was there, and Kenny Wayne Shepherd came and sat in for him. So there's a big jam session at the end with Billy Gibbons and me and Frampton and all the Double Trouble. You can Google Nashville Musicians Hall of Fame, and that was my jamming with his drummer and his bass player, who are really incredible guys. They were called Double Trouble.
Double Trouble,
right?
Yeah. Okay, Saul Schatz. A good Irish name? No, that's a joke. Okay, Saul Schatz, sailed with you on Rock and Romance Cruise just before COVID hit. Our group voted you the top performer of many great ones on that sailing. The Guess Who were scheduled to be on the next sailing. Would you consider performing with that group?
They're not the Guess Who.
That's all like replacements and stuff.
Why would I perform with them and give them some legitimacy when there are four clones or five clones who weren't even alive when the songs were hits?
Larry Mark says, have you guys been on any strange concert bills like Jimi Hendrix opening for the Monkees?
That was a great one. I remember that played Winnipeg, Hendrix opening for the Monkees. I did a show once with the Guess Who. It was in Iowa. It was the state fair. Our opening act was Rocky and Bullwinkle. Do you know what that is? Mm. That squirrel and a moose?
Rock and roll.
And all they had was a tape recorder with a thing from the cartoon. The guy had on men's underwear that were dyed brown and a paper mache moose head, and the other guy had a little 80-beater hat who was Rocky and Bullwinkle, and they went out and moved their mouths to the...
If you ever go back...
To the cartoon that was from TV.
Some of our viewers might not know what Rocky and Bullwinkle is, but it was a children's cartoon show in the late 60s.
Black and white.
And one time, I found an old video of it. This is like... 20 years ago or something, just before the video stores all start going out of business, and I found an old DVD or a VHS or something of old Rocky and Bullwinkle episodes and put it on. It was totally hilarious.
That's funny.
Yeah, it was really funny, like not little kid humor, like really funny kind of stuff. Barbara Stambaugh says, since you're both great guitarists, which other guitar greats have been the most fun to jam with on or off stage? Have you played with Joe Walsh? I've never played with Joe Walsh, but that would be pretty cool.
I've played with Joe Walsh, and back in the day when he was with the James Gang.
Yeah, we should do that song.
He's a really cool, wacko, phenomenal guy. He's known to every policeman on tour in the States and every hotel security guard.
He was fortunate to have come into his insanity in an era before smartphone video cameras and before there was... computer oversight of police activity.
Him and Keith Moon together destroyed hotels.
Well, the stuff that Joe got away with, and even you guys for that matter, from the cops, I mean, you'd never get away with it now,
no.
I don't think.
No.
But anyway, that's a whole book series. Let's do some of these ones.
Okay, this is Dido. Last summer, I had a great summer. Had many kids and grandkids came with me. We went to see Jeff Lynne, ELO, phenomenal show, Paul McCartney, Queen, and Dido. And the coolest was Jeff Lynne, ELO was phenomenal. And Dido
was like 2.5 hours of non-stop.
Dido was absolutely fantastic. I was one of the only guys at Dido who wanted to go there. The other guys were there because their girlfriends and wives wanted to go. But I went with my daughter and my granddaughters. And Dido came and sat right in the front of the stage and sang to everybody. It was really nice. A My tea's gone cold. My tea's gone cold. I'm wondering why I got out of bed at all. Morning rain clouds up my window, and I can't see it all. Even if I could, it'd be all gray. But your picture's on my wall. It reminds me that it's not so bad. It's not so bad at all. Drank too much last night. Got bills to pay. My head just feels the pain. Missed the bus. There'll be hell to pay. I'm late for work again. Even if I'm there, they'll imply that I might not last the day. Then you call me, and it's not so bad, it's not so bad. And I sing, wanna thank you.
I'm coming to play.
The best day of my life. And the drummer's coming in. And I wanna be with you. Having the best day of my life. So long. Push the door, I'm home at last. I'm soaking through and through. Then you hand me a towel, and all I see is you. If my house falls down, I wouldn't have a clue. Cause you're near me, and it's not so bad. It's not so bad, it's not so bad. And I wanna thank you. My life, and I'll just to be with you, having the best day of my life.
First line again.
My tea's gone cold, and I'm wondering why I got out of bed at all.
A new ending. Isn't that a great song?
Yeah, she's got a lot.
We're keeping up with Dido.
Thank you.
me love and always will be. I will go down with this ship, and I won't put my hands up and surrender. There will be no white flag above my door. I'm in love and always will be.
Nice.
Really simple, beautiful, powerful, you know.
Amazing lyrics.
I have a soft spot for these girl songs.
Yeah.
Like this. Like only a girl, well, you know, except for the recent version that we just did. But, I mean, really, it's only a girl that can really deliver these kind of songs, I think. And it's always cool when there's that vulnerability. There's like girl vulnerability. Instead of like, you know, I'm not saying there's no role for this, but instead of like the constant aggression and the you know what I mean? It's like, you know, the in your
it's
face
the opposite
and
the of heavy
obscene,
metal.
Yeah, like obscene stuff.
Soft,
like hip hop obscenity and stuff. Like, I mean, this is
Star too. It's
yeah, I mean, this is like a very powerful, feminine, attractive song for me, you know.
Her whole
I mean?
Show was fantastic.
Yeah.
Can I check my tuning?
Yeah.
Is that good? Just give me your That's close.
Okay, Dad's gonna do a version of this classic.
Hold me close and hold me fast. The magic spell is cast. This is La Vie en Rose. When you kiss me, heaven sighs, and though I close my eyes, I see La Vie en Rose. When you press me to your heart, I'm in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. When you speak, angels sing from above. Every word seems to turn into love song. So give your heart to the time. Always be, will be on road. Will be on road. Quan. Quan, email prawn, they say bra. Email parle tu bois. Je vois la vie en rose. Me difficile d'amour. Des motets sur les jours. Et ça me fait quelque chose. When you press me to your heart, we am a world apart. A rose with roses bloom. Your heart and soul to me, and life will always be La Vie en Rose. La Vie en Rose.
Okay.
Bra, Emile parle tu bois, le bois en vie en rose. Il me dit des mots d'amour, que mots de tous les jours, et ça me quelque chose. And when you press me to your heart, I'm in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. When you speak, angels sing from above. All the words turn into love song. So give your heart and soul to me, and life will always be La Vie en Rose. La Vie en Rose.
I know. You should do a solo.
French friends out there. Francais.
That was an interesting.
That was a
wandering version.
French train wreck.
Okay. Well, Larry Marks, back to that Jimi Hendrix Monkeys question about weird openings. I mentioned what?
Oh,
no. Well, I mentioned in a previous broadcast, the one that I always think of is like when I show up, I get invited to this. It's a music festival. I didn't realize it was like a hard rock, heavy metal festival, and it's in South Africa, and I'm there with my acoustic guitar, and I got to come out and do like a solo singer-songwriter thing with these completely hammered, you know, Afrikaners out in the middle of the desert near Botswana. It was crazy, but I don't remember which show I told that story on, but you can look it up. Well, you know, a lot of people ask this question. I don't know how to answer it. Brendan Oshier says, what is your all-time favorite song? Not because of a specific line or riff, just a song you will never get tired of listening to and still gives you that feeling a truly loved song can give you.
Never ask anyone that question. There's no answer.
Well, there's no answer.
I'll give you
for
one
us,
now, and
maybe.
I'll give you another one in the next minute.
Yeah. For, I mean, maybe for normal people, there's an
which
answer.
Of my children do I like the best?
Okay.
Right.
William Small says, have you worked with Frank Marino? That would be cool if you did.
I did with Frank Marino a long, long, long time ago. I think his band was Mahogany Rush, but out came Rush. And the name would like kind of, he was quite a good Hendrixy guy. I heard an incredible story about Frank Marino. Mm. Like he couldn't play guitar. He was very sick and had like a fever to kill, like 108 fever. And he was like in a coma and he came out of it and said, get me a guitar. And he started to play like Hendrix. That's the legend I heard way back, like in the 70s in Toronto. And I heard him playing. It was quite incredible.
What about the story of Dr. John, who starts off as a guitarist and then gets in a bar fight and somebody shoots his finger or
they
some
cut
weird
his fingers
thing?
Off, yeah.
Is that what? Well, I don't know. There's all these weird legends. I don't know what it's true. And then because he couldn't play guitar anymore, he learned piano. But he was a completely phenomenal and underrated piano player.
Yeah.
If you look on YouTube, you can see old... I mean, we're morphing into a new topic here, but you can go on YouTube and find old footage of Dr. John playing, you know, not just that cool, funky rhythm, but great solos, great lead stuff. Back to that favorite song question. What about you, Coco? You have a favorite song?
That's hard. So many songs. I like your songs.
I have like 200 favorite songs.
I mean, is there a song that they could put on repeat for 300 times in a row and you would never get bored of it?
Oh, that one. How long has this been going?
Thank you. the solo in that song.
That song you could play endlessly in my car.
What about Showdown?
It has one verse.
Showdown ELO.
Oh, yeah.
I could listen to that one 100 times in a row.
Every ELO song.
Every ELO song. Standing in the Rain, ELO. I've listened to that hundreds of times in a row. Dan Craig, I know Randy has done production in other bands, including Trooper Tal. Have you done any writing or producing with other performers? Well, not that you would have. Well, I've written with lots of famous
Jeff
songwriters.
For
I've written with lots of
guitar player.
Lots of famous other songwriters. But I haven't produced any big bands. I've produced a few things here and there.
You produced an album of mine.
Oh, that's right. I helped
Merge
you.
Album.
Yeah,
he helped
right.
me. He actually talked me into singing. Cause
that's right.
I was kind of shy to
there
sing.
Some,
like,
there's some great stuff on that record.
Every song.
Yeah. Eileen Donovan says, hi, Randy and Tal. The song Welcome Home, BTO song, has a line, silver vet with gold wheels. Is this Bruce Allen's car you're referring to?
Yeah, Bruce Allen had a silver Corvette with gold wheels. And it goes, silver vet with gold wheels. You see him drive around the town. He's never really up. He's never really down. He's just Mojo. His nickname way, way back then was Mojo because he got everything.
Didn't he have a license plate with the word Mojo?
He might have had Mojo.
Okay.
Bruce Allen is famous for his picture being in the Vancouver Sun that somebody made him a bet. They used to have a Hudson Bay downtown.
That's still there.
With a big clock on a clock tower. Mm. And so at like going to midnight, there's a picture in the Sun of Bruce Allen with a ladder holding onto the hand of the clock going to 12. You see this body hanging there.
Oh my God.
It was him on the clock on a Halloween dare, and that was in the Vancouver Sun, apparently. And when he got down from the clock, the police were waiting for him.
It was obviously a better time.
So this guy's for me. He's going to be my manager.
Margaret Rivera says, which one of you cooked dinner on Thanksgiving? That was me.
Tal did an incredible job. A turkey, two ducks, stuffing.
You know, it's a funny thing.
Mashed potatoes, gravy.
What I've noticed about cooking, I mean, it sounds obvious, but when you experience it, it's a different thing, is that there's no, the appreciation level, it does not in any way relate to the effort put in.
So if
you buy a pre-made meal, not that I did, and you just kind of whip it up, everyone compliments you. You know, they appreciate you for having put on the meal just as much as if you'd made it from scratch. But in that case, Margaret, I just got one of the Butterball pre-stuffed turkeys.
Yeah.
And they're always the easiest, they're the best. In fact, I think it was Cook's Illustrated, the magazine that I read years ago, where they had done the turkey taste test. This sounds like a commercial now, but I think the Butterballs won, if I remember correctly. So I always get the Butterballs. But you know what? The one little
and it cooked
tweak,
from frozen.
It cooked from frozen.
Yeah.
But you know how in cooking with everything else, it's sometimes the little tweaks, the little tiny things that make a huge difference.
Right.
And one thing that I always do when I make like the big poultry dinner is I'll pan roast or sometimes oven roast. Cashews and almonds.
Oh, yeah.
And I throw them onto the platter.
Oh, that was great.
And they really just kind of add a certain cool thing. Okay. Kathy Olson says, I heard that you played in a little bar in Taupo, New Zealand. Did you play in a bar in New Zealand when you went there? She says, we were there last November for a Sunday jam night, and the owner said you'd been there.
I was in New Zealand about 5 years ago with Bachman Turner, with me and Fred Turner. Hmm. And we were on a tour with America and Pat Benatar, and we played all the wineries in New Zealand, which was a government-sponsored tour. It was great. Whole families came. It was at noon outdoors. They didn't need any lighting. It was sunny, and it was just quite fantastic. We played every third day. Every other day we had off. We went and did anything. Everything was free from the New Zealand government. We went out in the mountains. We went into these wonderful hot springs that come out of the mountain that are full of white stuff like silica and all that kind of stuff.
But did you play in a little bar? Taupo?
Maybe. I don't think so.
Well, Kathy,
we might have went in somewhere. Somebody said play a song.
So some of these stories.
We didn't have a gig in a bar. No.
Yeah. So a lot of these people are liars, Kathy. But I'm not saying this guy is in particular. But there might be some connection. I mean, I went to New Zealand, but I don't think I played in any bars. I think somebody introduced me as like, you know, a guy that 100 years ago had a hit. But that was probably not the one. And it wasn't in Taupo. I've never been to Taupo. I was in Auckland. I was there for the World Cup. And on that note, Kathy, watch the Bledisloe Cup. Let's see if New Zealand can keep that trophy. Okay. Last question. Larry Marks. Hey, hi, guys. My question for both of you would be if you were forced to live on a desert island. Oh, yeah. One of these ones again. Could only take three albums. Which ones would they be? I don't know.
ELO's greatest hits.
White album, Out of the Blue, ELO.
ELO's greatest hits. Eagles' greatest hits.
Mm. Can we do compilation albums? That would be good.
And Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young.
It's always the same. Yeah. I mean, there's only, I bet if you ask
Carole King's Tapestry.
If you ask 1,000 people that question, I would bet you 83% of the answers would be, it would be the same 8 or 10 albums.
Because?
It's like Rumors or Eagles' Greatest Hits.
Guess
or,
what? I got a 12 songs. There's 12 great songs.
Yeah.
That's the thing about those, and especially when they're, I wouldn't take any real album, but I would take somebody's greatest hits.
Mm.
Tiny Tim's greatest hits.
There you go. Tiny
Tim. Are you
ready
for this?
Yeah.
Am I doing this?
Sure.
Do you remember the 21st night of September? Love was chasing the mind of pretenders.
Deceptively clever song. You know, you hear it on
it
the radio.
It sounds simple. Wow.
It just sounds like guys just... Let's do this one.
Great. Well, I got invited to write this song.
But another near miss. I've
another
had a few
wonderful miss. I was writing in England with a friend of mine named Rob Davis. He used to be in a band called Mud. And he's a great songwriter. And I'd been writing with him for about a week, maybe 2 weeks. He lived out in, where's the steeplechase? Epsom. And the Epsom salt mines are there and everything. So there's a wonderful steeplechase there. So I'll take the train from London out to write with him in Epsom. And he said, do you want to stay next week? I got to write a song with this lady and I don't know if I'll get along with her and stuff. And I said, no, I've been here for 2 or 3 weeks. I got to go home. This is in England. I lived on Salt Spring Island. So I didn't go to this. He called me the next week and said, I think I wrote a monster hit. And Kylie Minogue, who came from a show like Friends, I think it was called Neighbors in Australia.
Right.
She came to England. A new guy was made the head of EMI Europe, signed her, got this song, said, I'm going to make this my flagship, big successful thing because I'm new the head of, I'm now the head of Europe. And they did this song. So you're going to do it.
You know, it's funny. On the one hand, it's very hard to have a big hit song. Right. On the other hand, you maximize your odds so much when you get a guy that like has a clear vision. You've got an artist. You tell the songwriters what you want. Here's three reference points. Write a song that's in between these three reference points. And the Spice Girls did that.
Yes.
I mean, they're monster hits. And by the way, if Spice Girls had not done a lot of those hits and somebody with a lot more artistic credibility had done them like Stevie Wonder, the critics all would have loved those songs. But a lot of those songs, the Spice Girls songs, we should do one on another show.
Right.
Great, great tunes. And this one's super catchy. So let's do this
one. What we heard is the hit record was the demo he wrote and did in his little shed like this. And she's singing the vocal in his closet.
Yeah. That's another thing.
And what dead in the closet was he had three coats in there.
Yeah.
And a microphone.
Well, that's the other thing is you don't need a big studio, right?
And the next time I went to write with Rob Davis, he wasn't living in Epsom anymore, in his little attached house. He was living in a gigantic mansion out in Leatherhead. Beautiful place. Very good friend of mine. Oh, I've known these guys forever. These guys were called the Atlanta Rhythm Section.
Oh, that's them, eh?
They used to back Roy Orbison.
Great tunes.
And they used to be called the Candyman, because Roy Orbison had a song called Candyman. We used to call that. And so I knew these guys very well. They also were the house musicians for Joe Lowry's publishing company. And Joe Lowry had Bill South, Joe South, Walk a Mile in My Shoes, Billy Joe Royal, the Classics Four, and the Atlanta Rhythm Section was the like the Motown band. These guys were so good, they got a lead singer, and they sent them out on the road, and they had big hits with this song.
We did some of their songs in a previous show.
You were the sunshine, baby, whenever you smiled. But I call you Stormy today. All of a sudden, baby, that rain's falling down, and my world is cloudy and gray. Since you've gone away, oh Stormy, oh Stormy, bring back that sunny day. Yesterday's love was like a warm summer breeze, but just like the weather, you change. Now things are dreary, baby, it's windy and cold, and I stand alone in the rain, calling your name. Sunshine, baby, whenever you smile, but I call you Stormy today. All of a sudden, that rain keeps falling down, and my world is cloudy and gray, and you've gone away. Thank you.
Got time for one more song?
You bet.
All right, let's do one more and we'll call it a show.
We will. Oh, this is a good one.
And I can never get the timing right on this song, but let's
good,
try
I'll
it.
I'll follow you and we'll train wreck it. Oh, yeah. I've got your back. I'm with you on this.
I've listened to this song 100 million times. I still can't get the timing.
Well, the great thing about the Gypsy Kings, it's like following John Lee Hooker. He changes the chords when he wants to, or sings the line.
I always screw it up.
I know.
Yeah.
I play this. I love this.
Before we leave, friendly reminder, like the YouTube channel and
subscribe.
Yes, subscribe.
Say you like it.
Click like. So we get more views.
Yeah, then Big Tech gives us some money to offset these costs because we're making them a fortune here.
Happy Halloween. Okay. And this is Friday night, so...
Halloween.
Tomorrow is Saturday.
Are you going trick-or-treating?
So put on Randy's Vinyl Tap on CBC Radio 1. It's a good show I put on, and Tal helps me with that show. We're on every Saturday on CBC Radio.
Now, as I've mentioned many times before on this show, this song started a, you know, lifelong kind of... I don't know, fanhood or not,
yeah,
maybe not
like
obsession.
Whole, yeah.
This came out in 1987.
Wow.
I was a wee lad. And anyway, here it is. It's the Gypsy Kings. 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Bum, ba, da, da, da.
I don't know your three.
Ba-ba-da-da-da.
Wow, what an ending. Thank you all.
Thanks for coming.
We're done. See you next week. Happy Halloween. Be safe.
Yeah.
Have a nice weekend.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Coco.
Bye.